I want to continue with another subject, with another miraculous creation of Allah. It is the frog. We all know, we all have seen frogs, these little creatures that are always jumping around.
Yes.
So frogs are perfect beings that can easily travel long distances by jumping. Today, athletes exercise and condition themselves for many years in order to jump long distances and work out to prepare their muscles to jump, because jumping is a movement that puts a good on stress over all muscles. It is very complex thing. Since it requires all the muscles on the body working together, it causes a very serious amount of energy to be expended, and it's also a very tiring thing. But this movement, which is very tiring for men, for people, it is very ordinary and easy to be made for some frogs, for all frogs, in fact. After a person jumps several times, we all know that we left out of breath, but the frog is not even tired from this movement. The sources of frog's jumping characteristic is hidden in its creation. Some frogs can jump amazingly great distances. This jumping characteristic of frogs can have caught the attention of researchers from Brown University, and they have examined the working of frogs' muscles with the help of X-ray technology by filming the jumping process, the jumping of the frogs. So Henry Astley from Brown University, who examines the biomechanics of the jumping of frogs, points the miraculous situation of frogs jumping by saying muscles cannot produce such good jumps on their own. So he saw this miraculous thing in the jumping of frogs and say it very openly. As a result of detailed examination, it was found that the mechanical working of frogs' tendons function like water under pressure. What is behind the jump is the characteristic of stretched tendons. When getting ready to jump, tendons stretch and kick back during the jump. Before the jump, leg muscles shorten and load energy on every tendon, directs this energy on it with pressure and makes the frog jump. This pressure is so strong that it can cause the frog to jump far away.
In order to form this pressure, 1/4 of the frog's body weight accumulates on its legs. And in other words, when the stretching and kicking back under pressure do not happen, the frog that dwell on treetops and lives in water cannot maintain their lives.
Scientists who examined the frog's jump with three-dimensional X-ray technology realized that the jump is more complex than this. When the frog prepares to jump, its calf muscle shortens after exactly 100 milliseconds. Exactly the 100 milliseconds, these muscles stop working and energy is loaded onto the stretched tendons. During the jump, the tendons wrapped around the ankle bone releases this energy with the speed of an arrow that comes out, that is released from a bow. This resonance causes the ankle joint to enlarge very fast and throws the frog forward with pressure. And let us look at a video how this process is going on.
As we saw in the video, the jumping characteristics and muscle structure of frogs
is important to understand that Darwinist opinions mm-hmm. about the reptiles learning how to jump mm-hmm. and turning into frogs are really very wrong, because this great fallacy is because the jumping movement is seen by Darwinists as a very simple and learned movement, but as we saw on the video, it is really very complex system. It has to be a complex system to have this kind of a feature for a this kind of a very little creature, mashallah.
Yes, mashallah. However, while a being can learn to jump as much as it wants, it cannot alter the structure of its muscles or the working of its tendons. In order to make the anatomical changes in the body, all the genes and the DNA that that being would be must be renewed. The cells can build then tandem only if there is information on what the tandem will be like and how it will look and how it will work in the genes. No being has the means or knowledge to alter this genetic structure, his own genetic structure, and rewrite its whole gene map.
And frogs have not acquired this ability to jump through their own efforts and or by coincidences, but they were created this ability. Allah created them with this ability. And no doubt that Almighty Allah, the owner of the all things and the all the world, the one who creates the frog and who may give these properties and the structures to this little animal, mm-hmm. mashallah, Allah controls the metabolism of these frogs and all the other beings on earth, and every moment, every second, they are under the control of our Lord Allah. And in one verse in the Quran, Allah tells us, it's revealed that I seek refuge in Allah from the curse of Satan. I have put my trust in Allah, my Lord and your Lord. There is no creature he does not hold by the forelock. My Lord is on a straight path. It's from the Surah Hud, it's verse 56. MashaAllah, Allah controls every being,
yes,
the living beings and the non-living beings. Allah controls them in every second. Allah creates them in second by second. Everything is under the control of Allah, mashallah.
Research done has shown that frogs' muscle structures have an utterly perfect order. Like all beings on earth, frogs' muscle structures are also created by Almighty Allah with the finest details. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. All in your creation and all the creatures he has spread about there are signs for people with certainty. Surat Al-Jathiyah 4.